Hi everyone, this is Professor Manoj Sehgal, and I'll be talking of the last exam of the season, which is the MBA CET 2017. Now, this exam is held on 4th and 5th March of this year. One good part of CET from last year has become a structured examination, unlike when I gave my CET, which was a very jumbled up paper. Now, the four sections which have been declared by DT are like that. Logic will be for 75 questions. You'll have visual reasoning for 25 questions. Quant, DI and DS will be the next 50 questions. And verbal will be for 50 questions. So it is a 200 questions with a 2.5 hours on the final day. It will have 5 options and no negative marking. And I'm again repeating, no negative marking. So that's the best part of CET, is that you do not get penalized for your wrong answers. However, CET always has been a speed test. Roughly you'll have 45 seconds per question. So it is more like a T20 match which you're attempting on the final day. Looking at the last year CET, just giving you a brief idea how CET was last year. Let's see. In the last year, visual was the easiest section. Out of 25 questions, a good student could have scored anything from 18 to 20. So this section is the most important section for a lot of students. It is also a unique examination of CET. Visual is one of the heavy dominant sector on the final day. So this can be a game decider in this year's CET. Next section, which was the most difficult section of last year, was logic. You had 57 questions on verbal reasoning and 18 questions on non-verbal reasoning. In the 57 questions, you have 22 sets coming of arrangements. You had 2 sets of arrangement which were more on linear, 1 circular and 1 matrix arrangement. Each of the questions were very lengthy. Now this was one of the heartbreaking sections for last year. The third section was one of the easier to moderate section, which was the quant section. You had 24 sets of DI, you had 4 sets final day, and in the 24 questions of DI, you had 1 pie chart, 1 circular chart, 1 line chart, 1 and line graph. This was the easiest section on the final day. And the easiest section of the entire paper was English. 50 questions, 10 questions of reading comprehension, and 40 questions of the rest. Now the grammar could be filling the blanks, it could be jumble paragraph, it was para jumbles, filling the blank, double blanker, you name it, they had it. You had synonyms, antonyms, in fact you have a spelling also on the final day. So this was the easiest section in the last year's paper. So if I again check it out, last year the easier section was visuals, English, quant, and the tougher section was logic. I do not see a lot of changes happening this year. With IBPS setting up the paper, I think it will be more or less on the same lines. Maybe they might go down easier on the logic section and increase the level of difficulty. If I was appearing for this year's examination, my first attempt should be, and compulsory should be, English, followed by visuals. Now that will go rapid fire. Both the sections should be completed with 1 hour. Then depending on how my prep is, I could take an idea on basically logic or quant, depending on how I've been prepared for the earlier days. One major changes happening is there are 94,000 students appearing in CET, which is a jump of 30% from the last year. So a lot of people are attempting this year's CET. The big catch or the big fish or basically the brand seller is JBIMS. I do not know any other college except FMS which has such a good ROI. You basically pay 2 lakh fees and your average package is around 18 plus. So JBIMS is actually the crowd puller for CET. After JBIMS, it's Sydenham MMS which you should look into, followed by Sydenham PG, KJ Somaya, Wellinkers, Pumba, Pune, SIES, NL Dalmia, MET and finally St. Xavier's College. These are the top colleges in CET. In case you have specific doubts or difficulty or any queries, you can mail it to me. My email ID is manojsehgal@gmail.com. It is spelled as manojsehgal@gmail.com. No gaps, no underscore. Wishing you all the best for CET. God bless. Take care. Thank you so much.